There are various hormones in your body which control your appetite, fat storage, and energy expenditure. When you're trying to lose weight, make sure your satiety hormone called leptin does not come in your way. Leptin is a hormone secreted by your fat cells. In this video, I'll explain the main role of leptin. I'll explain how you develop something called leptin resistance, which is a prime cause of obesity. Finally, I'll tell you how to lower this leptin resistance to facilitate weight loss. As a bonus tip, I'll tell you some new evidence about another common medical condition that is also caused by leptin resistance. If you gain weight, you will get that condition too. And no, it's not diabetes nor fatty liver. Leptin's main role is to tell your brain if the body has enough fat stored for the rainy day. As one gains weight and stores more and more fat, more leptin is released in the blood. Consequently, your hunger goes down, your resting metabolic rate, or something called BMR, increases and your body maintains your weight. Unfortunately, in obesity, your leptin levels rise, but your hunger does not fall. This is because your body and the brain become less sensitive to leptin. So even high levels of leptin don't make your brain sense satiety. This is called leptin resistance and considered to be the prime cause of obesity. It is similar to insulin resistance, which causes diabetes. Unlike some other hormones like ghrelin, leptin does not work from a meal to the next. It has more of a long-term effect on food intake and energy consumption of the body. When you lose weight, especially fat, the leptin production falls. This makes you hungrier as you get leaner. That's why losing weight becomes increasingly difficult. So what is the solution? Since leptin has long-term actions, it does not help to lower leptin levels meal to meal. You need to reduce leptin resistance. Unfortunately, no one knows all the things that cause leptin resistance, but we know enough to say the following. Leptin resistance is found to be caused by inflammation in the hypothalamus, the region of your brain that controls your hunger. To reduce hypothalamus inflammation, reduce inflammatory foods such as processed carbohydrates, sugars, and trans fats. Increase anti-inflammatory foods such as fatty fish or fish oil, olive oil, tomatoes, green leafy vegetables such as spinach and collards, fruits such as oranges, cherries and strawberries, and nuts such as walnuts and almonds. Increase your protein intake to up to 30% of your diet. Reduce triglycerides in your blood by cutting down on carbohydrates. Triglycerides reduce transportation of leptin across something called blood-brain barrier, leading to your brain sensing less leptin. Get at least 8 hours of sleep a night, which reduces cravings and leptin resistance. National Institutes of Health, or NIH of the USA, advises moderate aerobic exercise reduces leptin resistance in people with obesity and diabetes. And now for the bonus tip. There is growing evidence that leptin also causes cartilage degradation, which leads to osteoarthritis and joint pain. Earlier, arthritis was thought to be caused by obesity due to the excess weight. But new research shows that high leptin levels have a role in causing obesity as well as osteoarthritis separately. So if you get your leptin in check, your weight as well as your chances of getting arthritis will come down. On the other hand, if you already have arthritis, lowering leptin is one more way of reducing the problem. Besides leptin, there are many other hormones that play a role in your weight management. Here's a video playlist that explains the roles of these hormones and how you can control them. And here is another 40-minute long video that talks about 39 other weight loss concepts besides controlling the hunger hormones. Give a like to this video and subscribe to this channel. Remember, ignorance is a bad idea when it comes to weight loss. Thank you.